Alright, so before I head on to the next main mission, I'm definitely gonna want to do this submission over here. A, because it takes place in its own unique location, and it's not just using the previous mission like this submission over here, but also because it actually looks a considerably bit more involved since it actually has Kodama for me to find, half the usual amount, and the reward is two Guardian Spirits. In fact, if I'm not mistaken, I believe those are the guardian spirits I could have chosen at the start, Kato and Isonare. So that's definitely worth doing as soon as possible. I might actually switch over to one of those two. I don't quite remember what the bonuses were. But it is nice to change things. I forget what guardian spirit I'm using now. I still think I'm using the snake dragon thing. But I might have switched it. Yeah, no, I'm still using that one. Mainly because it has both a gold and an Amrita bonus. Oops, I Amrita. I've realized recently that I've been pronouncing that improperly. So I'll try and correct myself. Okay, so much for it taking place in a unique location. It's just this place again. That's a little bit disappointing. Well, it looks like I'm being pointed directly towards a goal. I think I'm supposed to be hunting yokai here. So there's that at least. So I think I might just try and bum rush to my mission goals, at least the locations that I'm being shown on my map. That way I can get this over as quickly as possible, because if it's just an area I've been to before, I just want to get the rewards then. I don't really care about exploring again, although I should try and find the Kodama. I'll have to figure out what they look like on my radar. I now have like enemy sense, item sense, and Amrita sense, and Kodama sense if I'm not mistaken. So I'm being shown a lot of stuff on my radar. I just gotta figure out what the Kodama look like. I'm being a bit redundant here. So I may in fact have to explore this level a bit more fully than I would like. Can't leave those little guys behind. I'd be a cruel monster if I did that. Oh, I hate these lost soul enemies so much. Ooh, that low stance combo might be my new favorite way to deal with them. This, and then the forward X one that I can only do when an enemy is actually around. That's actually pretty good for dealing with them. Thankfully, these yokai don't seem all that difficult to deal with. I guess I am still a little bit overleveled. Oh right, that's the ladder shortcut that I can drop down if I proceed further. Gitaru Man. Okay then. So I haven't found any Kodama just yet, unfortunately. Oh. That's gonna be a tough fight, or at least as tough as I'm likely to find, given how strong I am. Let's use a Kekkei Talisman anyway. Ooh, that was definitely worthwhile. This is actually a technically new enemy that I have fought before in the beta, and he is just as tough now as he was then. Oh, I had always had a hugely difficult time fighting these jerks. So I'm very glad I used that Kekkei Talisman. Let me just take care of his assists first. Ooh, I already had to use two elixirs, and I think my Kekkei Talisman is gone, unfortunately. I'm not gonna use it again, not just yet. These guys, they just attack so quickly around you, they're difficult to deal with. Okay, there we go. Ki is drained, now I can just wail on him. Nope. Wow, I don't remember them wasting their ki this quickly. I wonder if that's a change they made, or if I'm just getting lucky with this one here. Well, it certainly worked out for me. Oh, I just realized some bit of inventory management I should do before I forget. I unlocked all my items when I was switching my gear around and I forgot to relock them. Not the weapons, except for those, but mainly my armor, and I'm going to want to be sure to do that. Keep this stuff that's actually pretty good and that I might want to level up. Ooh, this might actually be an upgrade for me. It's a bit weaker in terms of defense, but let me compare the two directly. It has the same change to defense from my spirit stat. Mostly worse stuff, but mainly it has that running speed boost. Yeah, that's probably worth sacrificing a little bit of defense. Okay, there we go. So let's see, is there anything in here that I actually need to do? That might have been one of my targets for beating the mission. I wasn't really paying attention, so I'm not sure. Oh, that might be the case. Yeah, that would actually make sense, doing the charge into the wall, causing him to lose all of his ki extra fast. I didn't realize that. That's the handy thing of having someone commenting on your playing. They can notice things that you're not going to because of all the hectic shit going on. Yeah, so I guess I apparently originally pronounced Amrita correctly and then I started pronouncing it incorrectly. It's not too surprising, really. If it's a fake word or a word that is not one I'm used to hearing, such as a word from a foreign language, I'm going to probably tend to default to pronouncing it like how I would think it's pronounced, rather than how it's actually pronounced. And that's why I keep wanting to call it Amrita as opposed to Amrita. You know what? Let me try and parry this dude. I haven't been doing parrying all that much. How was that a fail? I guess because his attack didn't even hit me. Ugh. Come on. Wanna be badass. Fuck it. Let's just do an EI strike. So good for these Skelebros. Just do that and then you do the finishing move. There we go. I didn't do the follow-up though. Let me just quickly check my skills menu to A, make sure that I purchased it, and B, double check what the input is. It's one of these. I'm pretty sure I have Haze equipped. And then when Haze succeeds, allows you to thrust attack with an extra square input. Oh, I think I might be letting go of the guard button, which is why that's not working. Let me just double check that I do have Haze in there and not the other parry move. Okay, so next time I fight an enemy that I can actually parry, I'll try that. Alright, looks like one of my other ghouls is in here. Another big yokai dude. I hope it's not, Mr. Charge, because, well, then again, I do have to get used to fighting that enemy type. Oh, it's a poison one. Oh, that's fun. High stance time. Okay, good. I got rid of his jerky helpers first. Oh, they do so much damage. Okay, there we go. I don't think I ever actually recorded that footage. I might have streamed it, but I didn't save it. But this is a far cry from how I first handled them when I first fought them in the beta. Oh, I get wrecked by that guy so many times. I think it took me like 30 straight minutes of trying to fight him before it actually clicked. And then in the next round, because it was part of a submission where they just threw waves and waves of yokai after you, after fighting that one, there was two of them spawned at once that I had to deal with, so that was fun. Okay, it looks like I only have one more goal here. I've yet to find any Kodama though, which is a bit worrisome. Oh, don't tell me not to worry about pronunciation type stuff. I'll worry about whatever I want to. You can't control me. I don't remember if you can parry these large skeletons or not. It's probably best not to test that. Because if I fail or if it is impossible, I'm gonna eat a lot of shit. You know what? I'm tempted to just go to the third location, kill whatever's there, probably another elemental variety of whatever that guy's called, and then just end the mission rather than looking for those four Kodama. On the other hand, I really do want to find them all. I can always do so later on my own time, of course. Okay, whatever I do, I'm taking out this jerk. There we go. Now I don't have to deal with him. There's two dots over here, maybe one of- okay, so one of them is indeed a Kodama. Let me kill this guy first and then see what color it showed up as on the radar. If I can actually move far enough away from it. So there's sort of a light green color, which does make sense. So now I know what to look for. Let's head back down here. It's kind of hard to tell the, oh, I think that's a green Kodama dot over there that's further up, actually. Okay. This shouldn't take too long if I just, trust in my radar. Seriously, the fact that you can get pieces of equipment that just tell you the location of various things on the radar is so ridiculously good. Like, that might be the best bonus possible type for a piece of armor. So if I read this, if I read this fight, I think there should be a Kodama nearby. Apparently not. Trying to tell if that's a Kodama or not. Ah, damn it, no, it's just an item. Ugh. I really wish the color differences were a bit more obvious, or that they used like more vibrant, more vibrant colors. Close quarters are not good for fighting one of these dudes. Okay, so that was a bust. I guess I'll just continue exploring along this way and I'll probably end up finding a Kodama. I was about to say, hey, that's a good use for that Spear's jump move, and then nope. Oh well. I guess I'll have to enter into that dank, I hate those guys, that dank temple-y area if I want to find more of the Kodama. Okay, let me deal with that dweller first, unless, nope, they're not interested in coming after me anymore. Okay, take these jerks. Let me actually try and explore the outside fully first. Oh, that's why I picked up the first one. Yeah, I'm thinking there might not be any more Kodama on the surface here. Okay, let's check in the deep, dank, dark dungeon. Let's plumb the depths of the darkest dungeon. That is literally my best attempt at doing the darkest dungeon narrator voice. Not very good, as you can tell. Hi. I've yet to figure out how to reliably hit with that leap move you can do. I guess I would- so if they move farther away, it's pretty good at hitting them. But if I stay close to them, if they don't try and dodge away, I end up leaping so far ahead of them that I can't actually hit them. So very situational, that move. Let's see if I can't please this new Akabe. Oh, he does not like me clapping my hands. What about a good old whistle? Nope, he's a pissed off boy. Improperly timed dodge. What else is new? Okay, that wasn't so bad. I gotta say, I do like fighting the Nurikabe. Ooh, another Kodama. They're just tough enough for me to handle that I actually have to pay a bit more attention than I normally do. And they're damaging enough to be punishing, requiring me to actually heal with elixirs, but without actually just insta-gibbing me. It's nice. Compared to most of the enemies who I have a pretty good handle on at this point, and thus, who aren't very threatening. One thing I hope the game does a bit more in the future is throw more groups of enemies at me, because talking about things killing me, I don't think that boulder trap was there the first time. Or maybe it was and I like took care of whoever throws down the boulder without realizing it, so let's try and head back there. I'm just gonna retrace my steps so I don't get lost, even though I have a quicker entrance in that house there. Actually, since the enemy's leash, I should just be able to run past them all, since I know my ultimate destination. But yeah, as I was saying, it'd be nice if they threw more groups of enemies at me rather than just these single encounters, or groups that can be easily cut down in size with sniping and stuff. Because consistently the most trouble I've had with Nioh is when I've had to fight groups of enemies. One of the submissions I did off camera in the second stage, actually, was just waves and waves of yokai that came after me, being summoned by a mandolin player, who also summoned a bunch of revenants after me. And that was, I actually ended up dying once there because it was just really difficult to handle. So I think I went down here. Yes, yes. So where did that boulder come from? This is what I'm trying to figure out. Like, I can't look up any further. Did I hit like a pressure plate? Let's just go for it. Wait, what? Did I just somehow miss the boulder passing, or what's that about? That was weird. Okay, well, that mystery... Hi. That mystery will never be solved, I suppose. Oh, you would be a good opportunity to practice parrying. There we go, that's how you do that counter move. A lot of damage, instant breaking of his ki. That might just be because those enemies don't have much of it, but very high ki damage at the very least. Of course, it's a lot more efficient just to use, you know, any of the other much more easy to use moves, but if you want to look cool, it's pretty effective. Oh, it rolled behind me after I got in the alcove? Huh. Lost souls continue to remain annoying. Oh, and a sentry. Let's heal up in case I eat shit here. Come on, Kodama. Where are you, my little friends? I thought I heard something. I don't think the big guy noticed me, so let me practice my parrying a little bit more. Okay, practice is not going so well. There we go. I'm wasting more resources than if I just used something easier, but again, I really like to look cool, and honestly, the more technical aspects of the combat are why I enjoy this game. Certainly not the difficulty, not so far. Although, again, that could always change. I am really hoping that the difficulty of the game just suddenly ramps up. Maybe when I get to the third region, or maybe even as soon as the next stage. The next main mission, I mean. Come on. Oh, okay, I see what you mean, talking about the boulder now. Ah, still no- Oh, okay, so these guys basically spawn when you check the item. That's annoying. Let's see, I've collected 2 Kodama so far, so I need 2 more. I think I've explored everything in this underground area. Now I have no idea where I am. God damn it. This way? Maybe? Oh wait, okay, I know where I am now. This, one of these stairways should take me quickly back up to the surface. Yep. That's what I thought it was. Actually, I think there might have been one more path over here. And I do want to try and work my way back to that area with the sentries that surprised me, because I don't think I had explored there yet. Since there were enemies still living. Hey, there we go. That was convenient. Oh god, no, no, no. No, no, no. Okay, well, that could have gone worse. Could have gone better, but as I like to say, I didn't die, and that's what counts. I think this takes me back to where I just was, yeah. Of course, one of you is real. Oh, and actually, it looks like it takes me right to my goal, too. Yep, so this is where I needed to go. I don't think any of those sentries are real. And actually, it's kind of a good thing I died, because it means I respawned with my Kekai talisman reuses. So let's use that. Let's use the catwalking scroll. And that should be good, I guess. Yep, this time it's a water elemental version. So, I don't think my summon's gonna be too useful since it's water elemental. I'm gonna be proactive with my heals here just in case. I gotta die. Should probably use low stance. Okay. Helpers are dealt with. Yep, so that drains all of the ki. Let's try summoning my guardian spirit anyway. Oh, it actually still did good damage, even if it didn't do the elemental build-up, since he's of the same element. Okay, that actually went pretty well. Of course, now to complete the mission, I need to go back down here, so... The other Kodama must still be on the surface somewhere. Okay, that's certainly an armor piece name. Demon God Visor. I think I'll be checking that out. Oh, look at that. That looks awesome. And really, I actually would like to get rid of these sense enemies things, because that would actually remove markers on my radar, so it would make it easier to see where the Kodama and Emrida are. Plus, it just looks badass as all hell. Oh yeah, look at that. Oh, and I didn't actually explicitly mention this, but in between last stream and this one, I unlocked the Baba shop at the blacksmith, and now William is a fancy boy. Not that we can see that with this demon god mask. What would that be in, like, Japanese? No, with my very limited knowledge of the language from anime, like, Makai Kami something? No. Probably not. I'm not even gonna make any more attempts at that. I'll just embarrass myself even more. Okay, so where haven't I been on the surface? Because I don't think I've explored everything. I haven't really been on most of the roofs, so there's a good chance there's a Kodama there. Not on this one at any rate. But I didn't like, I don't think I can check how many Kodamas I've found except by resting at the shrine. I'm pretty sure I found two, and I just found another one. So yeah, the dots are slightly green, but they look very similar in color to the white Amrita ones. Maybe I should get rid of the Amrita scents. What piece of gear has that actually? It is the Magatama. I do like the other thing it gives, the change to defense magic, since I have a moderately high magic stat, but I think I'll switch it out for something else. What would be good? Another Kodama sense. Shorten recovery time out of key. I'm pretty sure this is a DLC item, but that's an incredibly good ability. Yeah, going with that. Okay, so now it should be much... Wait a minute. Am I still seeing the dots on the radar? Oh, so I thought these were the things that Amrita Scent showed, but... Clearly it must be something else, unless I have another piece of gear with Amrita Scent. Let me just check through again. I don't appear to, huh. Well, if that's not what that is, then I'll re-equip that Magatama, mainly because of the really nice defense boost that it gives. Okay, I just gotta find one more Kodama and then that'll be it. Shouldn't be long now. Oh! It looks like it's right below me. See that little green dot on the radar? It's kind of faded out, which I'm guessing it means it's not at the same vertical height. So I don't think it could be on the ground, because I'm pretty sure I covered that area extensively unless I just somehow managed to miss it. Let's see where else I can drop from. I already tried there and there was in fact a Kodama over there. You know what, let's try dropping down. Maybe it is further below. Wait, oh, now I can't even see it, huh. So it must be higher up then? Was there a higher up area? I think that was as high as I could possibly go. Whoa, wait a minute, why am I... I was not doing damage to him. Huh, these must be like super lost souls. I'm doing key damage as opposed to actual HP damage. And I guess I need to exhaust their key completely before I can actually hurt them. That's interesting. Wait. I'm still doing no HP damage. What? Let me try switching weapon. Nope, I am still doing zero damage. What the hell is going on? Okay, if I can't hurt them, I guess I'll just leave. Maybe that's maybe because I've already completed the mission and I just need to continue on, it doesn't actually expect me to continue to fight the yokai? Or the enemies in the stage, rather, and that's why it's like that? That was really weird. It has nothing to do with the demon god visor, does it? No, it shouldn't. Yeah, hold on, where the hell was that green dot that I saw before? I saw it when I approached the main temple area. Yeah, see, it's right there, but there's no Kodama inside. It's a puzzle for the ages. And it disappears when I go closer to the ground, so it couldn't be in the underground area. Why is this taking so long? God damn it. I'm 3/4 of the way there. I really don't want to give up now, of all times. Huh. Oh, wait, I'm an idiot. I can get on the roof of the building. That's where it is. Yep. Bingo. Okay, let's get back down to where I can actually complete the mission then. So yeah, that was definitely worth doing, as much of a time investment as it was, because the additional Kodama will give me better Kodama blessings, which will help me in the next mission for sure. And those new guardian spirits may come in very handy. I think this is where I needed to head to. Maybe? Maybe not. I still don't have a very good mental map of this underground area. It's so damn confusing. I think I headed in the exact wrong direction, actually. Wasn't there a place I could drop down here somewhere? Okay, at this point I am literally just running in circles. Yeah, there was definitely some place I needed to drop down from. Okay, I gotta find the other staircase like this and then drop down the hole that's in the side. So where is that? Is this the staircase? Yes, yes it is. And I'm pretty sure that takes me where I need to go. Oh wait, no, it was the other way around. I needed to head up to the top of that staircase to get to the area. There we go, okay. My wandering suffering has been complete. Oh yeah, two new guardian spirits, and a young ninja's lock. So let's immediately see what the bonus is that those ones give me. So I picked up Kato and Isonare. So Isonare is water, I'm pretty sure, gives... Okay, everything gives the same amount of spirit protection. I wonder if there'll be any guardian spirits that give like higher or lower in exchange for other things. Sense enemies, life, ooh, close combat life recovery, that's very good. I believe, yeah, so when I defeat opponents in close combat, i.e. not at ranged, I recover 100 hit points, that's pretty significant. Human close combat damage and strong attack key reduction. Kato, on the other hand, gives close combat attack just in general. Extra key recovery speed, key reduction use while in critical health, and more skill damage. But then if I look at their living weapon stats, Kato provides a greater attack enhancement, is usable for less time, it recovers more quickly. I'm not sure what that means, I could check but I'm too lazy. Yep, so I think the game is pretty much saying use this Isonare, because Isonare rather. Bonuses seem a lot better.